Hello and welcome back to the second chapter of the QF test Java tutorial. In the first chapter we have worked with a sample test suite, and in this second chapter we will start creating our own test suite from scratch. And what are the steps we will see? The first is we will learn how to start the application, what is necessary for that. Then we will do recording actions, we will do recording of checks, we will organize our test suite, and then we learn how to create a stop sequence for the demo, and at last we will run the whole test suite. Okay, here I've already created a new test suite, which can be done simply by this toolbar button top left. And now we want to go through the steps necessary for creating a setup sequence for your application, which can be done by the quick start wizard that is available via the extras menu. And after it has come up and has welcomed us and shows a little bit of explanation, we can directly press the next button to be able to select the kind of application that needs to get tested. And there's the option for Java application, for web applications in a browser, which is explained in another tutorial. And there is also the option to test PDF documents. But we will stay with a Java application. And in the next step, then there is the information needed in which way the application is to be started. The typical way is that you will have an .exe file or a command file, something like that. But there are also options for Java Web Start, for Java Applets in a browser, or to launch a Java Archive or a Java class. We will stay again with the first option and press Next. Then we will have to provide the actual file to be launched, and I have already put that here in the clipboard. So to have that available fast, and it's the car config command script, which is located inside our QFTest distribution, inside the demo and car config directory here. So I will select that and open it. And yeah, then we can already press the finish button. There would be additional options to set in the following steps, but in our example, everything is fine. And so the finish button is perfect here. Here we will see a short summary of all the data we have provided. So press finish again. And now our setup sequence has been created. And we already know that kind of sequence from the first chapter and see that the data we have provided within the Quick Start Wizard is now inserted in the respective nodes to have this sequence. Okay, we can launch the setup sequence by simply pressing the run button. And after a few seconds, the car configurator demo shows up. And yeah, as last step in this section, let's save the test suite, which as is a new one. And for this, I can press the save button and here provide a respective directory. I have created here a directory within the personal documents folder. Simply call it QFTest Java tutorial, and inside this I can save my suite. For instance, let's call it my first tests. Okie dokie, so this was the first part here. Let's go on by recording some actions on the car configurator. For this we can press the record button here. And then let's record a small sequence. For instance, select the i5 model, change to the specials tab, select the JS specials model, and go back to the vehicles tab. And then to stop the recording, I press the stop button here and get a new sequence within the extras, which is our kind of playground for us. And the sequence has just a timestamp as default name. And within this sequence, we see the respective mouse clicks we have just performed. And let's provide a better name here. For instance, let's call the sequence Select Model i5 Jazz. And as a final step, we can try to execute this recorded sequence. And as we can see, it performs quite well. No error occurred. Okay, the next step would be to also have verification points, as within testing, of course, you don't just want to control actions, but you also want to verify that the effects and the results within your application are correct. And for this, there is another mode to record checks as well. And when having activated this and then switching to your application window, you can see that components are highlighted, the component below the cursor, and that is the one which is the one you can record a check for. And let's do that for the price value here. And when pressing the right mouse button, you can see that there are a number of checks shown, which are typically the relevant checks for that kind of component. And for a text label like that, you can have a text check. You can check whether the component is visible, whether it is enabled or editable, whether it has focus. Image checks are possible. You can record the geometry or tooltip if it's available. But let's go for the text check here. And again, press stop. And we have another sequence recorded, and it contains a check text node to the calculated price field. And you can see that the value that is used for the check is the one from the application. You see a double dollar symbol here. That is just a special syntax because the dollar is also used for variable syntax, just as a side note here. So also let's execute the check. It also works. Of course, we have not changed anything. And so let's also have a better name for that sequence. And let's call it check final price. Okay. Perfect so far. Possibly let's save the suite. Okay, so far we have just worked within the extras, which means in a kind of sandbox. But for having a real test suite, we need to restructure our recordings and organize that in another way. And to have real tests and real test cases, there are these nodes here, test set, which means there are groups of similar tests or tests which belongs to the same part can be put in here. There are also test cases. There are other nodes in the test suite. There's a space for procedures, for reusable parts. The extras we have already explained, and there is also one node for windows and components. And there are information stored by QF test which represents the components of your application. So to prepare our tests and our test set, let's give it a better name here. For instance, let's call our test set demo tests. When changing this name, we are asked whether we want to possibly update respective references that used already the test set. We have no references so far, and so I can say simply no here. And then what I can do to reorganize, I can put the setup node up here to have it as a setup for our test case. And also our test case, we can give it a better name. Let's call it simply first. And okay, the dialog comes again. Still no references here. And then we have our two sequences. And before moving them up, I would like to transform those nodes into real test steps. So far they are just sequences, but I would say these are real test steps, and this can be done by this transform node action from the context menu. It's also helpful that these test steps later on will appear in our report, so the reports will get better and have more information. So, but now let's move these two steps up here in this test case. And so now we have a real test case first. Now to finalize our first test suite, we need a cleanup sequence to stop the demo at the end. And this can either be done as it has been done in the first chapter, to use some kind of processing node to terminate the car configurator process, but we can also create another simple cleanup sequence simply by recording the normal exit procedure via file exit. And of course the car configurator disappears, and what you can also see that the record button gets deactivated because the car configurator is already gone, but we can still press the stop button and get our respective sequence recorded. File exit here. Let's call it stop demo. And we can also transform this node into a real cleanup sequence node. And after that, just move it upwards. And by that, we have our full test suite done. Let's save it. And also we can execute it and see whether it now runs well. And as expected, everything works fine. Finished, no errors. Okay, that's it. By this, we have finished the second chapter here. And now please feel free to take your time, get used to the recording functionality, try a little bit, play a little bit around with checks, with records, and yeah, have fun. And we will be back with the third chapter, and then we will see how to write a procedure. Bye, have a good time.